Hey you guys, what's up? Unrested here, and today I'm back with another NoNeg November video, and today I'm talking about something I've kind of confronted before, and that is making your own YouTube channel, but I'm not going to go ahead and stress how much you should make one, even though you should. I'm going to talk to you about how can making your own YouTube channel help enforce, get you ready for, or make you a better person for visiting Japan, especially if you plan to come here and work as an English teacher like many people do when they first get here. Guys, nothing wrong with that job. It's your foot in the door. It's the very first job I worked when I got here. Nothing wrong with doing that. And this is how doing YouTube can help you do just that. So number one is communication. Communication sounds like something that's pretty simple. I'm doing it for you right now as I talk to you on the camera. But it's something that doesn't always come natural to us when we're put into a situation where we have an audience, like right now when I'm talking to you. Yes, I can't see you in front of me right now, but I do know I am relaying information to an audience and not just to a good friend, and that really makes a difference. When you relay information to just your good friends, you feel very comfortable, very open, you're very used to how you would talk to that person, you don't really stutter or catch yourself or go ahead and filter out your words is another big thing. But when you're on video or when you have an audience or you're in a professional situation, yes, that becomes very important very fast. So what I suggest doing is first practicing by having your audience here on YouTube and getting used to being in front of a room of people you are teaching, where you do have to filter, you do have to communicate, you do have to use simple language or explain stuff in a simple way. And then that's not saying anybody's dumb or stupid that you are talking to, it's just that not everybody knows what you are talking about. For example, if I teach about a certain subject here in Japan, I cannot just start with the base Japanese words. I have to explain each and every Japanese word I use most times, because I don't expect everybody coming on here speaking fluent level Japanese. That's ridiculous. Nobody should have a channel where they teach in that manner unless they're on a very, very specific video site. On top of that, there is another way that you can hone your skills, and that is presentation. How do you present the different things that you're teaching? Do you use visuals? Do you use actual examples? Can you act out some of the things? Can you draw some of the things? Remember, there's going to be times here where even the English language is going to fail you. Even your Japanese is going to fail you because you might not know the Japanese word, or you might not be pronouncing it correctly. So visuals become very important to your presentation. Which ways are you presenting different visuals? So when I make a video, obviously oftentimes I splice in different pictures, especially when I do like Dark Side of Japan. If I'm teaching some of the kanji from those, I show the kanji so I can show exactly what they mean. I show old Edo era examples of paintings that relate to the topic sometimes. Especially when I do my Osoroshi Saturdays and talk about very scary subjects, that really helps sets the mood and gets people even more interested. So it's the same thing you can do with your lessons too. Think about the visuals that you're bringing to the table. Are you bringing in visual cards? Are you bringing in pictures, videos? Can you show them a clip of music, a clip of a video, a clip of your favorite TV show? Relate it to the lesson in some way. If you can do that, that makes the lesson a million times more interesting than just you standing there talking your head off the whole time. And last but not least, I think one of the most important things is confidence. Having a YouTube channel will start to give you a lot of confidence. Go back and look at JFAC number one. And I sound like a total doof on it. I can barely talk, I can barely pronunciate, I mumble. I'm very nervous on camera. It's pretty obvious that my voice changes when I'm on camera, but now I am completely relaxed. Yeah, I know everybody around me right now thinks I'm a total psycho idiot recording on my camera, but the good thing is I don't care anymore. I've done this so many times that it's not a big deal to me anymore. It's same thing with teaching. When you first get in there, you're really self-aware of your presence in the classroom, and you're thinking about everybody judging you with every single thing you say, and then after a while you start to realize it doesn't matter. Who cares if they really do think anything about you? Who cares if they like or dislike you, or you know how they feel about you? No matter what, you got to put yourself out there so that you communicate loud, clearly, don't stutter, don't stop, and have the confidence to continue through your lesson. Showing a really, really well-researched lesson that you constantly stop and start, stutter, and mumble through is way worse than you bullshitting your way all the way through a very clean, well-pronounced, well-said video or lesson. That's a little bit of ways that you can introduce YouTube into your life and make yourself a little more ready for coming to Japan if you're going into the teaching career, and other aspects of life too. It can really help with any job, I think. Until next time, I am Unrested with the questions you requested. Have a good one.